Number two, Phil Lynott.
But Thin Lizzy as a band were firing on all cylinders. They were unstoppable. Tremendous experience.
Guess who just got back today? That wild-eyed voice that had been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy.
He was one of the genuine, true rock and roll romantics.
Told them you were living downtown.
His lyrics had a capacity to evolve. And he had a wonderfully wry sense of humour on stage, suggesting that I'm a star, but you know, you and I know that I'm not really being a star, you know, that I'm really approachable.
Phil Lynott didn't just push the boundaries of music, he also challenged our ideas of what it meant to be Irish.
Spread the word around.
He was a Black Irish ambassador, which was an astonishing thing.
Friday night they'll be dressed to kill down at Dino's Bar and Grill. The drink will flow and blood will spill. And if the boys want to fight, you better let them. That jukebox in the corner blasting out my favorite song. The nights are getting warmer, it won't be long. Won't be long till summer comes. Now that the boys are here again.
It's sad to relate that there was no talking to him. He understood what he was doing. And tragically, he was a doomed romantic figure.
Doomed, perhaps, and certainly a victim of his own excess. But Philip Lynott still holds the affection of a very large number of Irish people.
And so to my number one, it was one of the most remarkable spectacles ever to take place on Irish soil.